Welcome in the class of molecular diagnostic. In this class, we will learn about the clinical diagnostic and their process. In this class, we will learn about the introduction to clinical diagnostic, clinical diagnostic process, clinical history and interview, physical examination, and the diagnostic investigation as well as diagnostic testing. The condition that affect the laboratory investigation will be also investigated in this lecture. So let's start with the clinical diagnostic. The medical and clinical diagnostic is the practice of the detecting, identifying and monitoring a disease or medical disorder. So the clinical diagnostic is the process of identifying a disease, condition or injury based on the sign and the symptom of a patient is having and the patient health history and physical examination. So further testing such as blood test, imaging test, biopsy and may be done after a clinical diagnostic is made. So the traditional model of clinical practice incorporate the diagnostic, prognosis and the treatment. The diagnostic classify the sick patient as having or not having a particular disease. So historically, diagnosis was regarded as the primary guide to the treatment and prognosis. So prognosis is what is likely to happen in the future and is still considered the core component of the clinical practice. The diagnostic process proceed as follows. First, a patient experience a health problem, means you when you face a disease or you feel like a illness, then you decide that whether you go to the physician or any hospital or whether you might not go for the doctor. So the patient is likely the first person to consider his or her symptom and may choose at this point to engage with the healthcare system. So once a patient seek healthcare, there is an iterative process of information gathering, information integration and interpretation as well as determining a working diagnostic. So the performing a clinical history and interview, conducting a physical examination, performing diagnostic testing and referring or consulting with other clinicians are all way of accumulating information that may be relevant to understanding a patient health problem. This is the clinical diagnostic process in which a patient experiences a health problem, then patient engaged with the healthcare system, then it will be enter into the clinical diagnostic process. So when patient want to or enter into the healthcare system, that the process is iterative, means there is information gathering process, there is information integration and interpretation done by the several health worker, including doctor, including lab technicians, and the working diagnostic is happen. So this has sufficient information when it is collected, means a clinical history and interview, through the physical examination, through the referral and the consultation and the diagnostic testing. After all, the communication of the diagnostic is sent with the doctor, and in this process, the patients, doctor and lab technician should establish a communication for the diagnostic. Then after this report, on the basis of the report the generated from the testing, a doctor decide for the treatment. The treatment, after giving treatment, the outcome should be measured. So the outcome from the diagnostic process can be accurately timely diagnosis, the diagnostic error and the near misses, the patient outcome, the system outcome, and learning from the diagnostic error, near misses, and accurate timely diagnosis. So this is the work system of the diagnostic team member, the diagnostic team member task, technology and the tool, the organization, the physical environment, internal environment is also integrated with the work system of the diagnostic process. Now, clinical history and interview is a very important thing in the clinical diagnostic process. So the acquiring a clinical history and interviewing a patient provide the important information for the determining a diagnosis and also establish a solid foundation for the relationship between a clinician and the patients. So a patient clinical history include documentation of the current concern, past medical history, family history, social history, and other relevant information such as current medication, prescription, and over-the-counter and dietary supplements. So the process of acquiring a clinical history and interviewing a patient require effective communication, active listening skill, and tailoring communication to the patient based on the patient need, value, and preference. So the clinicians need to know when to ask more detailed questions and how to create a safe environment for the patient to share the sensitive information about their health and symptoms. So obtaining a history can be a challenging in some cases. For example, in working with the older adult with memory loss, means with the Alzheimer's disease patients, with the children that cannot provide the sufficient information to the clinicians, or with the individual whose health problem limit communication or reliable self-reporting, means someone is cannot able to speak, then it will create a hurdle to the health worker to diagnose their disease. So in this case, it may be necessary to include some family member or caregiver in the history taking process. So there are a growing concern that a traditional bedside evaluation skill, history, interview, and physical exam have received less attention due to the large growth in the diagnostic testing in medicine. So these methods were once the primary tool for the diagnosis and clinical evaluation, but the recent exploration of the imaging and laboratory testing has inverted the diagnostic paradigm. The clinician often bypassed the bedside evaluation for immediate testing. The interview has been called a physician's most versatile diagnostic and therapeutic tool, and the clinical history provides direction for the subsequent information gathering activity in the diagnostic process. So an accurate history facilitates a more productive and efficient physical examination and the appropriate utilization of the diagnostic testing. So diagnosis remains fundamentally dependent on a personal interaction of a clinician with the patient. The sufficiency of communication between them, the accuracy of patient history and physical examination, and the cognitive energy necessary to synthesize a vast array of the information. So the physical examination is a hands-on observation examination of the patient. So first, a clinician observes a patient complexion, posture, level of distress, and other signs that may contribute to an understanding of the health problem. So if the clinician has seen the patient before, this observation can be weighed against the previous interaction with the patient. So a physical examination may include an analysis of many parts of the body, not just those suspected to be involved in the patient's current complaint. So a careful physical examination can help a clinician refine the next step in the diagnostic process. It can prevent unnecessary diagnostic testing and can aid in building trust with the patient. So due to the growing emphasis on diagnostic testing, there are concerns that physical exam skill have been underemphasized in current health professional education and the training. So now I am closing this session, and in this lecture we have discussed, and you should aware of what is the clinical diagnostic, what is the clinical diagnostic process, and which process is involved for when a patient encounter with the disease, and when they enter into the diagnostic process. The clinical history and interview importance for the clinical diagnostic process, the physical examination, the diagnostic investigation, the diagnostic testing, means anatomical or pathological testing or radiological testing we have gone through. The condition that affect the laboratory investigation is also briefly discussed with you. So thank you all for the attending this session. So these are the some references by which you can learn more about the molecular diagnostic, and just go through with this references and learn more about the molecular diagnostic. So in नेक्स्ट क्लास वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द क्लिनिकल डायग्नोस्टिक ऑफ डिजीजेज. सो थैंक यू फॉर लिसनिंग.